So what's the difference between an MD and a DO? Because MDs represent about 90% of the fully licensed physicians in America, and DOs represent about 10%. So DOs are the minority, and I'm a DO, but I am a dermatologist and subspecialized as a Mohs micrographic surgeon. So this whole myth of DOs aren't specialists or DOs can't do certain things, that's just completely false. In fact, there are some specialties that DOs can do that MDs simply can't because they don't have the training for it. The difference between MDs and DOs is more philosophic in nature, because DOs historically have been taught to focus on the whole person, the mind, the body, the spirit. And we fundamentally believe that the body can heal itself as long as it has the right impetus to do that. So DOs philosophically are trying to get the body to heal itself, to try to self-regulate itself in a healthy manner. And even though a patient, when they come in to see an MD or a DO, often there's no discernible difference between the two, the underlying philosophy, it's slightly different. Now, MDs and DOs still have to take the MCAT, the Medical College Admission Test, and they still have to score really well to get into medical school. Both have to complete 4 years of medical school and then have to complete residency programs, which now are the exact same residency programs. So if you go to a family practice residency or a neurosurgery residency, they're the same programs between MDs and DOs. The difference being that the residents, well, they have slightly different philosophical backgrounds, but basically the same education. We can do all the things that MDs can do. We are in the same institutions that MDs are. There is less name recognition for DOs because we represent 10% of the total physicians out there, but we're roughly equivalent. In fact, some of the most highly positioned doctors in America are DOs. The doctor to President Trump, Dr. Sean Conley, he's a DO. The doctor to Vice President Biden, Kevin O'Connor, he was a DO. So if some of the most prestigious, some of the most highly sought after positions in America belong to DOs, I think that tells you everything you need to know. Now, some people like the philosophy of an osteopathic physician more than an allopathic or a medical doctor. If that's the case, I really encourage them to go to an osteopathic medical school. If you kind of want that whole mind, body, spirit, holistic approach, you're going to get that philosophy more at a DO school than at an MD school. If you're more of a cut to the chase science, cut things out, throw a medicine at them and get it done type person without going into all the warm fuzzies of mind, body, spirit, well, maybe MD is the better way to go. Now, it doesn't mean that MDs can't be warm and fuzzy or that DOs can't be all scientific-based, cut and dry. It doesn't mean that at all. It just means the education that you'll get is going to be slightly different depending on which type of tradition you want to study under. There are some residency programs that are predominantly MD still, and because of that, there is a bias towards selecting MD residents. And MDs are going to have an easier chance getting into those. Well, dermatology is one of them. Orthopedic surgeons, another one of those. So there are some residencies that there are still a bias present for MDs over DOs. And if you really are gunning for one of those residencies, well, you probably need to go the MD route to have a better shot. Doesn't mean you have to. Obviously, I didn't. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you found it valuable, please subscribe below so that you can get up-to-date content when it's released. And please share with your friends and family so that when they're going through similar things, they have the knowledge that they need.